Planning effectively is the key to achieving a successful implementation. In this series of design and implementation tutorials, you'll learn design best practices and how to troubleshoot, analyze, and use the provided system monitoring tools to improve performance and customer experience. In this tutorial, you'll see how to follow best practices when designing planning applications. When designing applications, you identify the requirements to help determine the design. Ensure that you understand the business process. Have a clear understanding of the customer's measures for success. These include the expected performance for forms and calculations. Will there be a focus on end-user-driven calculations or more centralized calculations? If you properly identify requirements, then you'll be able to design an application to best support the customer's expectations. To get the design process started, take a look at what the customer currently uses for planning. Do they use Excel spreadsheets, a homegrown system, or Oracle's on-premise planning? Define what the sources of information are and familiarize yourself with their business processes. See what is working well for them and improve on areas that are not working as well when incorporating needed processes into the design. Apply the 80-20 rule. Determine the key revenue and expense areas that make up 80% of profit and loss. Focus your application on the major drivers of your business by spending time designing for those areas that are most impactful. Keep the process simpler for the less impactful areas. Confirm whether all business units within your organization follow the business processes you identified. If the processes differ between business units, determine if you want to keep the current processes or adopt new ones. If you choose to implement different solutions by business unit, then identify those differences and which business units they apply to. Typically, satisfying analyzing and reporting needs is the primary objective for your application. Creating appropriate reports is the key to ensuring that customers can retrieve the information they need. Ensure that your application design and included dimensions match any reporting requirements. Defining the dimensions needed on reports helps you to properly configure your application. If reports are created by cost center, year, account, or customer, ensure that those components are built into the application. Identify if additional dimensions, such as product or customer, are needed. Do you plan on a monthly or yearly basis? How many years of historical data do you need to maintain? And how many years into the future do you want to plan? This will determine what the year dimension will look like. What are the currency requirements? Will you have a single or multi-currency application? Evaluate what data you need to develop an annual plan and forecast. Will you follow the same process to collect data for plan and forecast? What level of detail do you want to forecast? Will it be a simple forecast or a rolling forecast? Will target setting be used? If you use targets, will you set high-level targets and cascade down to the account level to get the data? Will multiple iterations be required? If you need to plan and forecast with multiple iterations, set up versions in the application. Determine the granularity for actual, forecast, and plan. Actuals may be more granular than what forecast and plan require. Determine all data sources. Where will metadata and data be sourced from? Is it coming from Oracle Human Capital Management, NetSuite, or a flat file? What data will come out of planning, and what will the flow of data look like? You need to balance the planning reporting needs with the scalability and performance requirements of the application. In your application design, keep data entry requirements separate from reporting requirements. Determine the dimensions needed specifically for data entry versus reporting. From the total dimensions identified, determine if the dimension is designated for reporting, data entry, or both. Dimensions used in reporting only should be leveraged into a reporting queue. Data integration can be used to seamlessly import actual results into your reporting queue. Typically, you can use the reporting queue to compare actuals versus budget or forecast. Consider aligning your customer's requirements to Enterprise Planning Cloud. You can then quickly implement a solution to meet your customer's EPBCS requirements. Doing so, you can leverage from out-of-the-box functionality and automatically see product enhancements as they are incorporated into the business processes. In this tutorial, you saw how to follow best practices when designing planning applications in Oracle Planning and Budgeting Cloud. To see the next video in this series, click the link on the right. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.